Hi, my name is Clisties Carter, and I am the fifth child of my mother. My past has not been a picture of beauty. I grew up knowing that my biological father beat and kicked my mother in the stomach trying to abort me. After divorcing my dad, my mother drank heavily. That marriage was also abusive. He raped my oldest sister several times. I remember growing up loving him, but being scared of him. In the third grade, all the children were taken out of the home because of the rapes, the drinking, and the destructive behavior of both parents. My parents were wishy-washy in their beliefs about God, so we didn't get any instruction about how to find peace and unconditional love. It sure wasn't modeled in my family. I was looking for love when I met my first daughter's father at 14 years old, and I became pregnant shortly thereafter. He was very abusive, so I took my daughter and left. By 21 years of age, I had three more children. And after putting them to bed at night, I would drink and smoke marijuana. I was introduced to meth by a friend of mine. She told me it would give me energy and help me lose weight, and that sounded good to me. But that was just the beginning of the nightmare of a life. My life was drugs. I did some deplorable things to support my habit. I lived on the streets for about 15 years, doing whatever I could do to get the drugs I craved. Drugs cloud your mind so that you can't think of anything past the next high. I even went years without seeing my two sons and two daughters. I would call them just to hear their voice and hang up without saying a word. During all this time, God was protecting me when I was not aware of the dangers of my lifestyle. I didn't like what I was doing, but I didn't see any escape. I had an ideal of God, my ghetto God is what I called him, but I never sought refuge in him. Although I spent time in prison for possession of a large amount of cocaine, nothing brought me to my knees until my son went to Afghanistan and was killed after being there only 2 weeks. I didn't know it then, but God was going to turn my life upside down and inside out. It was 2013, and I was in the cocoon of jail. God was going to make me a new creation. I was tired of running. At 40 years old, I had been in and out of jail since my teenage years. Back in jail, I was so filled with guilt, shame, and grief that I could not eat or sleep. That's when I went to the Good News Jail and Prison Ministry Thursday night class. I cried through the entire class. At the end of the class, I asked if I could talk to someone about the grief over the loss of my son in Afghanistan. I accepted the Lord when Pat Townsend, a Good News volunteer chaplain, met with me the following Monday. I finally found that unconditional love I had been searching for all my life, and God immediately gave me a thirst for him.
I remember the first time I met Clisty. It was in that class that she had mentioned, and she cried through the whole thing, and her grief was very visible on her face, in her body language and everything. She was very deeply ingrained in the grief. And so we met the next day, and I asked her if she would tell me about her son. She told me about David and about how she had not been the mother that she wanted to be, and that she was sorry that had all taken place, and now she had lost him. And I asked her if I could tell her about another son, and I told her about Jesus and how he had died on the cross for her sins, and that her past, she didn't have to carry that any longer, that he had died for that. And I also told her that he wants to have a part in her life to help her make good decisions and wise decisions from there on. And she just hopped on that. She wanted that so much. So we prayed and together, and I showed her what to say in the Bible, and I showed her what she needs to do is turning her life over to Jesus. She did that day. And the next time I saw her, she was radiant. I mean absolutely radiant. You knew something had happened to Clisties. And so we started meeting weekly and sometimes two or three times a week for Bible study. And she would bring questions of how she had read scripture through the week, and she had some questions and she wanted them answered. And so she would bring those to me, and that's what we would spend our time on, is answering those questions. And some of them were very difficult. They really put me on my toes. But she was so intent on learning more about her Jesus. We prayed together. We shared our lives together. I told her about my kids. She told me about the rest of her kids. And it was just a glorious time of bonding a relationship, not only with each other, but with Jesus.
I was so excited about what I was reading and learning from the Bible that I couldn't wait to get out of jail and begin to really live life. Before I left the jail, I was court-ordered to the drug court with its many meetings and appointments. The judge presiding over drug court remarked one day that he had noticed a change in me, and he liked it. He asked me what had caused the change, and I told him, it's Jesus. Even with my new life in Jesus, life was a struggle. After leaving jail, I lived at the House of Bread and Peace, which is an excellent place. While I was grateful to have a place to sleep, I dreamed of having my own home soon. I worked three temporary jobs until I was blessed with a full-time job working second shift. I would attend Bible studies on Saturday morning after working all night because I wanted to know more about my God. I applied to Aurora for housing and was put on a waiting list. In a miraculous short time, I was placed in an apartment with newly painted with all new appliances. The first thing I had put on the wall in the apartment was a cross opposite the front door. I am making amends with my children, and God is doing miracles with this. I still grieve over the loss of my son, but God is walking me through that journey. When I am not working, I attend Sunday services at City Church, and I am a part of the Second Chances Ministry. Jesus has set me free of the bondage of sin and the lure of drugs. Since February the 28th, I have been clean 2 years. I am so thankful for God and the Good News Jail Ministry. God is so big. He has changed my life, and I just love Him.